And good evening, I'm Erin Burnett. Out front tonight's celebration, President Trump celebrating and trying to capitalize on his Mueller moment.
The Mueller report was great. It could not have been better.
Of course, the president has not yet seen the Mueller report, but his definitive answer that it could not have been better is one heck of a change from the more than 1,100 times Trump attacked Mueller in the Russia investigation over the past 2 years. The New York Times actually counted all his attacks through last month. All of those witch hunts and hoaxes added up to 1,100. Now, though, it's all great. And the president is trying to make sure this moment does not pass him by. His Justice Department tonight backing a judge's decision to scrap the entire Affordable Care Act, pre-existing conditions and all. And the president is loving it.
The Republican Party will soon be known as the party of health care. You watch.
You watch. Watch what? I mean, so far, President Trump has provided no plan and not one single specific. Even though, since President Trump took office, support for Obamacare has grown. According to the Kaiser Foundation, which has been tracking the views of Obamacare since the beginning, the unfavorable rating now at one of the lowest points since it was signed into law, all the way down to 39%. Taking this on is a big risk for Trump, because if he gets rid of Obamacare, he gets rid of pre-existing conditions, and that would be extremely unpopular. And it would also be going against his own word.
Except pre-existing condition, I would absolutely get rid of Obamacare. We're going to have something much better. But pre-existing conditions, I want to keep pre-existing condition. I think we need it. I think it's a modern age, and I think we have to have it.
Just to be clear again, today he backed a judge's decision that would strike down the entire ACA, including pre-existing conditions coverage. So it is not just a promise he made there in the debates, right? It's a promise that the president made just a few months ago, again and again, heading into the midterms.
Republicans will always protect patients with pre-existing conditions. I wish people would get that into their heads. We will always protect patients with pre-existing conditions, always. Always.
The pre-existing conditions and all the other things were with 100%.
100%? We'll try 0% if the president gets his way. Again, right? They backing a judge's ruling that would get rid of Obamacare, including pre-existing conditions. That's a fight Democrats are loving. According to exit polling during the midterms, 4 out of 10 voters said health care was the most important issue. And of course, Democrats won. Now, the president could, you know, try to eventually come around and say, OK, now I want health care that covers pre-existing conditions again. But he's got to pay for it, which, of course, is the whole problem to begin with on this one. And reality is not stopping Trump from trying to seize his Mueller moment. Caitlin Collins is out front live outside the White House. And Caitlin, the president in a great mood on Capitol Hill today.
Certainly in high spirits, essentially taking one more victory lap as he went up to that lunch today, thanked those Republican senators for sticking by him during this investigation, and said, Erin, that he feels like he got a good, clean bill of health from the Mueller investigation. Now, he told those Republicans that he wanted to move on to other issues like health care, but as you noted, didn't provide any kind of concrete steps for that. But also, he made clear that he's not putting this Russia investigation behind him. He wants to use it as a political weapon. And right now, the president and his aides and his allies are really enjoying the position they feel Democrats are in right now, straddling essentially calls to make this report public, but also to move on to other issues like health care and education ahead of the next upcoming presidential election. Now, just to give you a sense of how much the president is in a good mood and how much he's enjoying all of this, he doesn't often go to these lunches. Very rarely does the president go to Capitol Hill for this policy lunch. Instead, it's something typically Mike Pence tends to do. But the president went up there and he wanted to make a point, Erin.
He sure did. And enjoying his moment, crowing from the mountaintops. Thank you very much, Caitlin.